I search the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. Then you came along and put me back together. And every desire is now satisfied here in your love. And oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing, nothing is better than you. And oh, there's nothing better than you. And there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing, nothing is better than you. And I'm not afraid to show you my weakness. Seen them all, and you still call me friend. 'Cause the God of the mountain is the God of the valley, and there's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again. So there's not.
Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a sling in my voice and a stone in my praise, pushing back when the darkest weapons form. There's a power on my lips even death can't defy, when the name of our God is lifted high. 'Cause there is resurrection power when we sing the name of Jesus. Resurrection power when we raise a mighty sound. So come on, let the praise get loud. Make that empty grave resound. 'Cause there is resurrection power in His name. There are days I have seen filled with heartache and loss that have buried my heart beneath their weight. But every time this praise breaks out, dead things arise up from the ground, and I won't leave my song inside that empty grave. 'Cause there is a resurrection power when we sing the name of Jesus. Resurrection power when we raise the mighty sound. So come on, let the praise get loud. Make that empty grave resound. 'Cause there is resurrection power in His name. Come out of that grave, come out of that grave. When we sing, captives, let go of those chains, let go of those chains. When we praise, dead men, come out of that grave, come out of that grave. When we sing, captives, let go of those chains, let go of those chains. When we praise, dead men, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
The hour is dark, and it's hard to see what you are doing here in the ruins and where this will lead. Oh, but I know that down through the I'll look on this moment and see your hand on it and know you were here. And I'll testify of the battles you've won, how you were my portion when there wasn't enough. And I'll testify of the seas that we've crossed, the waters you parted, the waves that I've walked. We're singing. It's a story I'll tell. And oh, I know it is well. And that's the story I'll tell. Believing gets all. And all
is highest praise. So sing hallelujah to the rock of ages. All that is left, and all that is left
is high and praises.
So sing hallelujah to the rock of ages.
All that is left,
and all that is left
is high and praises.
So sing it, sing it. So sing testify of the battles you've won, and how you were my portion when there wasn't enough. And I'll sing the song of the seas that we've crossed, the waters you parted, the waves that I've walked. We're singing, oh, 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 my God did not fail. And oh, 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 that's the story. Testimony. Oh, 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 I know it is well. And oh, 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 that's the story I'll tell. That's the story I'll tell. Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What a height of love, what depths of peace. When fears are still, when striving cease, my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. Death of Christ I live. Oh.
slain, but then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since first has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, born with the precious blood of Christ. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny.
Good morning. I'm so glad you're joining us this morning on Evangel Church of God Without Walls. We pray that today's service will be a blessing to you. Just want you to worship God and receive from the Lord. It's time to receive our tithes and offerings. There's different ways that you can give. You can go to our church website and give. You can give on the Church Center app, or you can text the amount to 84321. Or you can mail to the church, 12 West John Street, Lindenhurst. So we want you to give. And you know that you can't outgive God, and his blessings are rich. So if you'll just pray this prayer with me this morning, with joy, I bring my tithes and offerings into the storehouse. My tithes and offerings now belong to God. I claim an open window blessing. I claim an overflowing blessing. My needs are met according to his riches and glory. My family is blessed. My children are blessed. I am blessed. Amen. Amen. Thank you for your faithfulness. I want you to turn with me in your Bibles this morning to Genesis, the 38th chapter, and we're going to start with the 28th verse. Something that the Lord has been stirring on me for just the last couple months is breakthrough. Breakthrough. And so in Genesis 38 and 28, and so it was when she was giving birth that the one put out his hand, and the midwife took a scarlet thread and bound it on his hand, saying, "This one came out first." Then it happened as he drew back his hand that his brother came out unexpectedly. And she said, "How did you break through? This breach be upon you." Therefore, his name was called Perez, which literally means breaking through. Breaking through the breach. Breakthrough. I believe that God wants us to have a breakthrough. Whatever situation, whatever problem we're going through, God wants us to have a breakthrough. Would you just stretch your hands this way? Would you pray with me and for me? Father, I pray for the next few moments that your anointing would rest upon me, God, and not only me, but move in every home. God, on however people are watching, let your anointing touch them, God, and minister to them. Father, do a great work in their lives, and God will never fail to worship and praise you. in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. What a great story. Here is a story of Tamar, who is giving birth to children from Judah. And we know that Judah means praise. Amen. Thank God for praise. He is praised. Praise him. That is what Judah means. And because Jesus is the Lion of the tribe of Judah, he comes from Judah, that he is the Lion of praise. And so praise is very important. But here we find that there are children being birthed to Judah and Tamar. The first one, they were twins. The first one stuck out his hand, and the midwife saw that his hand was out, and she tied a thread around it because he would be the first one. And it's very important to know which one is first, because the first male child is the one that gets the blessings. It was the one that the father would bless. He would become the one that would take over and receive the blessings of the father. So his hand was tied with a scarlet thread. But his hand went back in. And then all of a sudden, the other brother came out. And the midwife was shocked. And she said, how did you break through? How did you come out and the other didn't? How did you come out through the breakthrough? Excuse me. How did you come out with this breakthrough? How did you make it through the breakthrough? But here he was receiving the birthright. He was the one to receive the birthright and the blessing of the Father. He made the breakthrough. Now listen, there's a lot of us that you've been going through some things. You've had some rough times, some things in your life. You need a breakthrough. You need a breakthrough in your finances. You need a breakthrough in your health. You need a breakthrough in your family. A breakthrough. But God is about to give a breakthrough. Judah is about ready to give a breakthrough. Now, in this, Perez being the one that broke through first, he's the one that came out first, although his brother stretched out his hand. We find in Matthew 1, verses 1 through 3, that in the lineage of Jesus Christ is Perez. He broke through and he stepped into a destiny of being in the lineage of Jesus Christ. Let's read that. The book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham begat Isaac. Isaac begat Jacob. Jacob begat Judah and his brothers. Judah begat Perez and Zerah by Tamar. Perez begat Harezem. And Harezem begot Ram, and then it goes on and on until you get to Jesus. You know what? God has got a destiny for you. God has got a purpose for you. God has got a blessing for you. God wants you to walk into it, but you need to get a breakthrough. You need to break through to get where God wants you to be and for the blessing and the destiny that God has for you. Don't let nothing hold you back. Breakthrough. Don't let nothing keep you down. Breakthrough. Don't let the devil build a wall up that you can't get through. Breakthrough. Get your breakthrough. Amen. So here we see the breakthrough. Judah means praise. Praise gives birth. And then there is a breakthrough. And then there is a destiny. But now you got to understand, and this is where I'm going to do some teaching. Perez was a twin. There was another in the womb. The other tried to get out first, stuck his arm out, got the scarlet thread put on, tried to steal the breakthrough or the destiny of Perez. If he would have came out first, if Zerah would have came out first, Perez would not have had the destiny. It would have been for Zerah. But there we see that Perez broke through, pressed through, broke through. Pastor, what are you talking about? You know, the Bible talks about Thomas. Doubting Thomas, we've called him a lot. Thomas literally means twin or twain or two. Thomas means twin. And we can see where Thomas, at some times he was one person, and at other times he was another. We see him saying, I doubt this. If I could touch his nail-scarred hands or if I could see his side, then I would know that it's really him. Until I see it, I'm not going to believe it. And then we find him again saying, oh, Lord and Master and Jesus saying, Thomas, you see because you believe, but blessed are those who don't see and yet believe. So in every one of us, Paul said, I find in myself another law, another person, another thing that wants to war against me being blessed from God. In other words, when I would want to do good, I did evil. There was that other person. And so we've got to be careful about who breaks through. We've got to be careful about in our life who breaks through. We don't need the old man who we used to be to break through and we miss out on our blessings. It needs to be the new man who Christ redeemed and saved and set free. We need to break through here, there. Our biggest battle in this world is not with the devil, but with ourselves. We battle ourselves. So therefore, we cannot allow the old man to break through. We cannot allow fear to break through. We cannot allow fear to overcome us. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love and power and of a sound mind. So we can't let the old man of fear break through. We can't let the old man of unforgiveness break through. We can't let the old man of bitterness break through. We can't let the old man of doubt break through. Amen. We've got to allow the new man in us to break through and to get that destiny and reach out. But the old man is always going to press forward. That old man, that other me is going to want to press through to get out. But I've got to be the one to break through, push back the old man and break through into the destiny and the blessings that God has for me. I've got to push back doubt. I've got to push back fear. I've got to push back unforgiveness. I've got to push back who I used to be and press forward to a new man, breaking through to the very blessings of the Lord. Amen. Breakthrough. So first, our breakthrough is with the old man and the new man. We have our breakthrough. Too many times we find that people miss out because they allow the other person to flow up. We miss out on our miracles because we allow fear. We allow doubt to rise up when we need to rise up with faith. You need to have a determination to get your breakthrough. I'm going to say that again. You got to have a determination to get your breakthrough. And Perez, Zara was breaking through first, but Perez said, no, I'm going to be first. He pulled back. He pressed forward. He broke through. And the midwife was like, how did you do this? How did you get this breakthrough? Your name shall be called Perez. Breakthrough. Breakthrough the breach. Make it out first. Receive the promise. Receive the destiny. That's what we need to be. We need to be determined to stand on the word of God. Worship God and praise him. Reach out and break through. Don't let nobody hold you back from the blessings of God. Get your breakthrough. Amen. Don't let nobody put you in a box. Get your breakthrough. Don't quit. Don't give up. Get your breakthrough. Too many times we give up. Too many times we surrender, or we get satisfied where we are and we don't get our breakthrough. We get satisfied in the place we are and we don't get our breakthrough to where that God wants us to be, and we're walking in the blessings of the Lord. That takes determination. It takes praise. It takes putting the old man down. It takes walking in faith, walking in the promise, standing on his word that we can break through and get to our promise. So many times people never receive their breakthrough. They come to church sad. They never get that victory, but God is calling the church to a breakthrough. In 2021, God is calling us to a breakthrough. We've been held down, pressed back. We're battling a pandemic. We're battling coronavirus. We're battling fear. We're battling so many things coming against us. But God has got a breakthrough for us. We can break through. Amen. We can break through and get to our destiny. In your marriage, you can have that breakthrough. In your home, you can have that breakthrough. In your family, you can have that breakthrough. In your finances, you can have that breakthrough because you press forward, because you stand on the word. You don't let fear, you don't let doubt be the first one out. You break through and you walk in the destiny and in the promise of God. We see Perez, here Perez. He becomes in the lineage of Jesus Christ. He is part of the lineage of David, flowing down from Judah. But you got to understand, his birth wasn't all that great. His mother Tamar, her husband died. Judah was her father, and Judah promised her husband's brother, but never came through. And so somehow, and you can read it, but Judah becomes the father of these children. And it just seems like a mess. But out of that mess, Perez broke through. You don't have to let where you come from hold you down. You don't have to let your past hold you down. You don't have to let generational curses hold you down, or where you flowed out of, or what neighborhood you came out of hold you down. You can press forward and rise above all circumstances. You can break out and be more than what God, that the devil tries to hold you back. You can be what God has called you to be if you'll press forward, push forward, breakthrough, hallelujah, breakthrough. Get your breakthrough. And God's got a miracle for you. God's got a miracle for you if we will allow the Lord to do it. If we will walk in a breakthrough spirit, walk in a breakthrough faith. I'm breaking through. I'm coming out. I'm not going to let my past hold me down. I'm not going to let my past circumstances hold me down. Where I come from, hold me down. I'm not going to let the old man rise up and fear and doubt. I'm breaking through. I'm going forth. I'm going first. I'm going to be the breakthrough. I'm going to be the one that breaks through. I'm going to walk in my destiny. You can walk in your destiny. You can have that breakthrough. All we've got to do is trust God. Make your breakthrough. Break out. Break out of your circumstances. Break out. He breaks every chain. You can break out. I think of Peter. Peter put in jail. And in jail, there was a jail breakout. Peter was in jail. He was chained to two soldiers. But an angel showed up, and the angel smote him, and when he stood up, the chains fell off. It will stand up, the chains will fall off. And the gate opened up, and Peter walked out, and he was free. There was a breakout. Paul and Silas put in the inner jail. There was a breakout. At the midnight hour, they began to sing and praise, and there was a breakout, for their stocks fell off, and the bars opened up. There was a breakout, not only for them, but all of them around him. There was a breakout. And there's a breakout for us, a breakthrough. We can make it. We can break through. God's got something better for you. Don't stand where you are. Breakthrough. Rise above it. Praise God. Stand on faith. Stand on promise. And you can break through. You can get to your destiny if you'll believe God and if you'll trust him and receive your breakthrough. I believe that God is speaking to me and for the church that this is going to be a season of breakthrough. You're going to break through. The church is going to break through. There's going to be a season of breakthrough. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Would you just stretch your hands right where you are? Lift your hands. Father, I pray right now for every person that is listening. Every person that has heard this word, I pray, God, that you would touch them. Holy Spirit, that you would encourage them for a breakthrough, God, of through every circumstance and every situation a breakthrough. A breakthrough of their past, where they come from, a breakthrough. God, that the old man, that man of fear, that man of doubt, will not be the one that goes forth, but the new man of faith and determination breaks through, and there is a breakthrough in their life. I pray, God, right now for every marriage, a breakthrough, every family, a breakthrough, God. I pray for the church, a breakthrough. I pray breakthrough through health. And God, we just thank you for it and praise you for it. God, let there be a breakthrough in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Even as I'm praying right now, I'm going to pray. Father, I pray right now for everyone that is battling this coronavirus, Lord. I pray, God, for healing, quick recovery in their lives. Father, I pray your touch right now in their lives. God, do a miracle, Lord. Do a miracle in their lives. Do a touch in their lives, Father. Bring them through with victory, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And God will never fail to worship you and praise you and magnify you. You are the God of the breakthrough. You are the God of the breakthrough. And we are the people of the breakthrough. So I pray, God, right now that you would touch every life. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want to thank you for joining us this morning. I pray that this word has been a blessing to you. I pray, God, that it has encouraged you and uplifted you, and know that you can have your breakthrough. And your breakthrough is there for you. So we pray right now for that. In the name of Jesus, I pray that this was a blessing to you. If you'll lift your hands right where you are, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord shine his face upon you and be gracious unto you. May his countenance overshadow you and give you peace and give you rest. Now to the only true living God be all glory, praise, and honor now and forever. In the name of Jesus Christ, God bless your people with a breakthrough. In the name of Jesus Christ, we love you, we thank you, and we're praying for you. Amen.